start walking straight. Tonight you're the life of the party. And the bar lights come on at your paper parade. You don't have to chase down. Yeah, I'll leave the light on for you. It's not your birthday. It's not the 4th of July. Tomorrow's a work day. You got a life and a spaceship to fly. Yeah, you got a good job. You know you can't chase the stars underwater. You can play all the notes, you can write all the words. You're headlining all the big cities. The spotlights are off and the crowds have gone home. You should be going home too. Cause it's not your birthday. This isn't Mardi Gras either. Tomorrow's a work day. You got a life and a spaceship to fly. You got a good girl. She gave you this beautiful yellow-haired daughter. Come back to Earth, kid. You know that you can't chase the stars underwater. No, it's not my birthday. I should be done waking up on the floor. Tomorrow's a work day. Don't you know you're not a kid anymore? You married a good girl. Oh, she gave me this beautiful. Blow out your candles. It's better than letting them burn out.
Good. Tonight, one million fires burning. I'm there, I'm alive, I'm alive. races like Cherokee, a blue motorbike, a pacifier in the moonlight, teenagers in the alley cursing. I smell the gas from Sucker Street sign. Shadows you can hear if you listen.
I can't get to you. I can't get to you. I'll tell you what, man.
What?
This show, this tour, these days, like I'm doing everything within my power just to just breathe in this, the moment, the second at hand. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I'll be honest, I don't need to tell you how just absolutely fucking weird the last couple years have been. We've all been there together, right? We've been in it together. I've played my ass off. I found ways to play shows, and a lot of you were at those shows, and I give you my gratitude, my whole heart for making it possible for me and my band to survive and to eat in the middle of the craziness. But it feels in this moment so beautiful to be back on stage with the tension lowered and the pressure down, and just people just wanting to sing and get fucking crazy and sit side by side with strangers. But we're not strangers here tonight, we are friends. And you feel like if I was gonna throw a birthday party, I'm super glad I would have invited every goddamn one of you. So let's get weird. I'm gonna sing you a love song. I wrote this song on the other coast. I was in New York City staring off at a skyline and just thinking how these beautiful buildings that have endured through centuries are a great metaphor for the love that I've had in my life. The love of my wife, the love of my daughter, the love of my family, my parents who are in the audience tonight, my wife who's in the audience tonight, my friends, high school homies in the crowd tonight. This one goes out to anyone who I've ever loved, and actually that's just about all of you. It's called Love in Great Buildings. Building on the verge, a testament to days more optimistic. Market shifts can cause storm systems to converge. Love. Things are much too thin. She asks me if I'm sick. What's a girl to do with friends like this? She lets me drive a car so I can scornate from the lesbians I was in Venice.
Let's go! Last transmission from the island radio.
I promise the show is not going to be as good.
Take a bite!
Give it up for my mom, my dad, and my sweet wife, Kellyanne. It puts a finer point on some things. Those three folks, I mean Bobby too. Bobby, I mean that was beautiful, I really. But it makes sense going into this next song because there was a moment in my life where the three of them, my sister, my brothers, and my older sister were everything to me, right? They shored me up. All of this madness sort of fell away because I had to get better, and I wanted to get better quick, and I did. And a lot of that was you guys too, because so many of you were out there just fucking willing this thing to come back to life. It's been 17 years. Can you believe that? 17 years, man. I'm the least shameless self-promoter, but I will promote for one thing, which is the foundation that I started in the wake of my cancer diagnosis. It's called the Dear Jack Foundation. I've lived in Orange County long enough to know that there's a lot of fucking money in this room. And if you got it, all you got to do is text Dear Jack, D-E-A-R-J-A-C-K, to the number 44321. Change the lives of some young people who are facing a cancer diagnosis. All right, let's do this one for them tonight. It's called Swim.
Dance all night. Oh, 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 oh ugly cars. I think I'd be in some empty bars. Might be wrong, moon or Mars. Either way,
even when the room is empty, even when the bottle's full, even when the door gets broke down, love can break in. Maybe when I'm done with thinking, maybe you can take me home. Maybe when I'm done with endings, this can begin. This can begin. Thank you. Turns out I got some friends in the neighborhood who know. Choked up here. Give me a second. Come see me, man. Thank you. to learn.
Thank you.
damn, I missed you.
Thank you.
So welcome to the stage, my brothers in arms. 20 years ago this past May, we put out a record called Leaving Through the Window. That's Mr. Josh Partington on the guitar, my right arm, my fellow co-songwriter and something corporate. That's Kevin Clutch Page on the bass. Mr. Brian Ireland on the drum set back there. We used to give him shit back in the day, but it's nice to hang out with a handsome man in our 40s, so give it up to the marvelous Mr. William Tell. I'm gonna add one little story here. We asked Zach if he would sit on the keys with us tonight. A lot of keyboards, a lot of vocals on these Something Corporate records. When I first met Zach, he was just, I mean, I think he was almost a teenager. He was a Something Corporate fan growing up, and we became fast friends because he would show up to the shows with lots of beers for the Jack's Mannequin guys. And he told me stories about driving around in the car with his mom listening to Something Corporate records, and I thought, what could be a more beautiful thing for this night, this harmony, this birthday party, than to have one of my best friends in the world join one of his first favorite bands on stage for a little singing and playing. This is a road trip song. Sing it like you're on the road with me.
Here I am. Are we all here? Here I am.
We wanted to play you mostly Leaving Through the Window tunes because we're woefully bad at celebrating anniversaries, and his birthday came up. I was like, dude, we should come out. We should play some Leaving Through the Window songs. But we thought, for the sake of the fact that we're all on a stage together, we could at least do one tune off of the North album. Is that cool, you guys? This one's called She Paints Me Blue. Dear Jack benefit, I guess it was 2016. I would guess that probably some of you were there. I was so ratcheted up, it was like hard to appreciate the fact that all of my bands were gonna play on a single stage. Tonight, I'm like, I'll admit, a little ratcheted up, like a little bit. But I feel the appreciation. I feel like the fact that these beautiful, beautiful human beings that raised me, we went to high school together. I mean, we were kids in Orange County playing music together. Exactly, they all got together for my birthday. I love you. I wrote this song when I was like 17 years old, and what's crazy is when I see a kid in the audience, I have to reconcile the fact that I wrote that song closer to their age than the age that I'm at now. But that's okay. That's okay. Because all you can do is age fearlessly, right? You gotta believe you got the best shit ahead of you. And I do believe it. I swear. This one's called Straw Dog. Try it tonight. The closer I get to feeling, the further that I'm feeling from alright. The more I step into the sun, the more I step out of the light. Jessica's covered in a blanket on a Sunday porch. During the weekend she'd party in the city. She doesn't have a flame. She prefer to burn out like a torch. If she gets to know every life, at least she knows she's pretty. She said, hey, now the straw dog's out in the street. Hey, now there's chemicals in the clouds. Hey, now they call out the police. But they won't get to us anyhow. Shadows always left of all the noise. Simple silhouettes and cutouts, as if we had the choice. Innocence closing now, swears that he can hear a voice that's calling him. Stay with me. She said, hey, now the straw dog's out in the street. Hey, now there's chemicals in the clouds. Hey, now we'll be right back. little crazy. I said, do you want to get a little crazy? This one's called Hurricane. Thank you. to come here, cause you're gone for more. What did you possibly expect under this condition? Well, slow down. This night's a perfect shade of sun blue, sun blue. Have you ever been alone in a crowded room when I'm here with you? I see the world will be burning down, burning down. Sun blue, sun blue. Have you ever been alone in a crowded room? Processing your like youth in the middle of a scene with 2,000 people that sold out a show. It's a very, it's a peculiar. Like I called the SoCo Boys up. I don't know, maybe like a couple months ago. It was after we'd already booked the show and put it up for sale. And I was just like, it's gonna be my 40th birthday. Would you guys come out and do this thing? And they, just like the sweetest men on planet Earth, they're just like, we're there for you, man. We're gonna do this for you. And I've not always been the easiest person to get along with. I'm not sure I'm actually still, even now, the easiest person to get along with. I'm probably like a middle easy person to get along with. Good, the band's not making any faces behind me. That's good. But to be on this stage and to share this stage with so many friends tonight, and to be in front of, fuck you, Bobby. I don't know what you're up to, but I know that you're up to.
Man, that was Mikey threw a pig at me in the chest.
Yeah, whatever, man. Look, I'm not going to bore you with my stories. What I'm going to say is just thank you. Thank you for coming tonight. Thank you for selling this show out to me. I was scared it was going to happen. And you fucking did it, Orange County. You put it up and we won. And I love you from the bottom of my heart. I've got new music in my body. And in my speakers, and slowly but surely, it's gonna be drifting out into your speakers. And look, it's hard to hang in with a band or a songwriter for 20 years. It's not easy. And I will tell you, I'm right there with you. But just fucking hang in with me, man, because I feel like I'm making some of the best music of my life, and I'm so excited to share it with you. We got one new song. One new song, and we're going to drift back into the wilderness of nostalgia together. So you think you got it in you? You got a brand new song in your heart? I wrote this for my wife of 16 years, my girlfriend of 21 years, the mother of my daughter, the fucking keeper of my soul. Kellyanne, you're in the audience tonight. I love you with all my heart. This one is called Stars.
The stars Thank you.
Yo. We don't exactly know what's about to happen, but we're just gonna do it anyway. When I was like 15, 16 years old, growing up listening to K-Rock and 91X in Orange County, there was one band that like really scratched the itch for me, and that was Cake. Look, I know we got people from all walks of life, people who joined me in this music journey like recently. And then there are those of you who were there with me like in the coach house when I was like a baby. Whether you know this song or not, all I request is you just freak the fuck out. Reluctantly crouched on the starting line, engines pumping with thumping in time. Green light flashes, the flags go up, churning and burning. They yearn for the cup, they deftly maneuver and muscle for egg. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent but secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. Long ago somebody left him in the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. Come on! He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's overlooked by love in a time of need. And because he's racing and crazy and plotting the course, he's fighting and fighting and riding on the course. He's going the distance. Something he cannot define. Bowels shaking, earthquakes of doubt and remorse assail him. Impaling with monster truck force in his mind. He's still driving, still making the grade. She's hoping in time that her memories will fade. But he's racing and pacing, plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. Somebody left with a cup. But he's driving, driving, hugging the turns and thinking of someone for him. He's still burning. Cause he's going a distance. He's going for a speed. She's all enough for love in a time of need. But because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course, he's fighting and fighting, fighting on his horse. He's racing, pacing, plotting the course. He's fighting and fighting and riding on his horse. He's going a distance. He's going for speed. Let's fucking run!
Oh, you're beautiful!
But I Happy fucking birthday to me, goddamn. All right. I hate to be predictable. But you know, I'm a type A guy. Like, I actually kind of like to be predictable. Here's the thing. Down the street, in a town called San Clemente, where... That's where my heart belongs. Orange County is my home. I wasn't born in this town. It was years, years into my life. Now, actually, it seems like very few years into my life, relatively speaking. But, I love it. My sound guy is literally in my ear. He's like, there's a fucking weird thing dangling over your shoulder. I love you, Trox. Give it up for Trox, man. Give it up for Trox. Whatever. No, I love you. No, dude, because that's the thing. This crew, the Wilderness crew, these guys that have put this show up night after night for the last 7 weeks, give it up for this crew, man. Trox, Vince, Terrence, Mauricio, Brian Buckley, Danny Samet. I hope I'm not missing anybody. Am I missing anybody, Vince? I think I got them all. Anyway, Ron, our amazing fucking bus driver. God, I bless you, Ron. We literally tore panels off of the roof of our bus while we were crowd surfing in the front lounge for fun.
We allegedly.
So, okay, I did. Okay, I did it. All right. I'm gonna spare you all. I know you want to go home. Oh, you don't want to go home? Don't tempt a motherfucker. Fine. We'll do two more songs. I'm gonna do this one for my amazing sound man, production manager. He always wanted this song to be in the set list, and I was just like, I don't think they know it. You know what I'm getting at, don't you? It starts with a C, it ends with a shin. It's called Crashin'. It was a... This song, when I was bouncing back from cancer, it was... And I wasn't bouncing back, I was a mess. I was an absolute effing mess. And you can ask my beautiful wife who sat in that fucking house on Mulholland and on Silverwood Terrace, who watched me fucking stew and trip and freak out. I couldn't figure it out. But I found this song in the midst of all of it, and the lyric was, even if your voice comes back again, maybe there'll be nobody listening. You know what I mean? Because like in the bottom of my heart, I'm always afraid that you won't be out there when I get here, you know what I mean? But I don't say that. I don't say that for gratification. I say it because, like, it is in me. It is deep in me, this, like, fight with my confidence, you know? And nothing, I love you too, but nothing. And I just say it, I'm not saying it for my gratification. I'm saying it for you who might be sitting out there and feeling like nobody might be listening to you. Just fucking sing and scream and believe in yourself, because there's somebody that will be listening to you. And if tonight is any proof, there will be somebody out there listening to you. And I'll sing this for you. It's called Crashin'. It's the first song of Jack's Mannequin's second record called The Glass Fucking Passenger. And we're gonna do it for you.
Just like that, without a
Sing one last song for good friends. Thank you for crowding in here. Thank you for selling this show out. It was beautiful. But we got one more moment available to us. So let's try and put the future out of our minds for just a second. Let's take a deep breath together and let's sing this one because it's about friendship. It's about love, it's about the people who sat, my best friends, my high school homies, who sat in a house, a condo in San Clemente, and heard these songs for the first time when I was so terrified to play music under a new name. I'm gonna sing this one for you, my Good Times crew. I love you, all of you. It's called La, La. Wow. It's been the probably the best first day of my goddamn life. Thank you so much, Anaheim, California. Let's hang out. Let's get coffee together.
Have a beautiful night tonight.